Hey guys, how's it going? So in today's video, I'm going to demonstrate the video performance of Lenovo Flex 5. This is the Lenovo Flex 5 4700U processor, the AMD Ryzen 8 core 16 thread processor, and this has 16 gig RAM. There is another configuration of this laptop, which is also 16 gig RAM, but that comes with a 6 core 12 thread processor. So that's Ryzen 4500U. So I've already reviewed this laptop in detail, and you can find that video. It's linked in the video description below. But in today's video, I want to show how good the performance is if you plan to use this laptop as your video editing machine. So a lot of you folks were asking if you can, you know, edit videos on this laptop. So what I've done here is I have DaVinci Resolve, my favorite video editing software, running on this laptop. And this is the latest version of DaVinci Resolve. And I have a couple of clips from my camera. This is 4K 100 Mbps files. So first thing I want to point out is, as usual, I have generated the optimized files. I always do that when I use DaVinci Resolve, because that gives me much better performance. And I will go full screen. And as you can see, I can easily scrub this file. Easily, you know, go back and forth, smooth like butter. Similarly, this other file here, same story here. So the performance is pretty amazing. And if I go here and open my task manager, let's go to the performance here. Let me minimize it. So see, as I am, you know, scrubbing, you can see the CPU is around 50% and GPU usage is around 25%. So it's not even taxing the system that much. And you know why this is? Because you have got 8 cores and 16 threads. So this has more than enough horsepower to deal with, you know, a high quality 4K file, 100 Mbps, bitrate, no problem. So let me demonstrate some simple, editing features which I use. So I have added a title and I have added some special effects on this clip. So let's, render it in real time. So as you can see here, the 4K demo comes out pretty smoothly. And I love how smoothly I can scrub through. I really love the performance here. Let's make the text a little more fancy. So I will go here in the editor and I will add some drop shadow to give some 3D effect on the text. And let's see how, if it affects the performance or not. Okay, so let's go back. Render it again. No problem. See, smooth 4K demo came. So yeah, that looks good. So let's do some more editing, simple stuff. So as you can see here, I have two different clips and I have added some transition effects here. So let's play that and see how the transition effect works. Okay, so you saw that effect here. Let me play that again. It's a stupid effect, I know, but I'm just trying to show all the, video editing features. So that, no problem here. Let's try some more effects here. Let's come here and let's render this effect. So this is a different kind of transition effect. I actually don't use any of these when I make videos. I like to keep my videos simple, but if you want to go crazy, you can. So as you can see here, everything is working great. Let's do some more fancy. Let's put a heart. Let's see how that looks. So I will put a heart here and let's render this. Oh, did you see that? That was cool. So here you go. Okay, so that's fine. And if you want to, cut the file, see, I can go to the blade mode and now I can chop the files. And then if I want to delete these files, I can easily do that. Let me exit the blade mode. Okay, so I can delete these files and they snap right back. Pretty good. And as I'm scrubbing here, you guys can see how smoothly it is scrubbing. Let me make it a little bigger if you guys are not able to see. Okay, let me scrub again. See how smoothly I can scrub. This is 4K file. This is 100 megabits per second file coming right out of my camera. And look how smoothly it's editing it. Fantastic performance. So I really love this laptop. The 8 core 16 thread model with 16 gig RAM. I mean, this configuration, this guy, this is a beast. And it's really light. I mean, this is a very light laptop. And by the way, this is a touchscreen laptop, and so I can scrub using my finger if I want to, as you can see here. And while editing, this is really nice. You know, you can, you know, literally go touch your video and edit it, which gives it a nice, you know, feeling. And like I mentioned before, there is also a 6-core 12-thread version of this laptop with 16 GB RAM, and that also will give you pretty good performance. As you saw here, only 50% of the CPU was actually being used. So even a 6-core 12-thread model is going to work great for this kind of video editing. Okay, so what I will do is I will now render a 4K version of this file, and we will test how good the performance is. So this is a 1-minute clip, and I want to see how much time it takes when we render a 4K file. If it renders at 24 frames per second, then a 1-minute clip should take exactly 1 minute. And if it renders slower, then it should take a little longer. So let's see how much time it takes. Okay, so I will render in MP4 and I will keep everything default. Select 4K resolution here. Everything else I will keep default. Let's call this file 4K. Let's add that to the queue. So let's start rendering. Let's go to our task manager here. So the CPU is now 100% used. All your 8 cores and 16 threads are now working full time, and the GPU is 20% being used. So here is the thing, guys, if you're using a free version of DaVinci Resolve, this is one of the drawbacks of the free version. It does not use hardware acceleration for video encoding, you know, when you are using the free version. So as you can see here, the video encode is 0%. So it's not even using the full power of my laptop. Now, if I go get the license for the studio version, I think it's $299, $300. If you pay $300 and get the studio license, you will get even better performance, because then the video encoding, the hardware acceleration will be enabled, and it will utilize the Radeon GPU that right now it's not using at all. As you can see here, it's 0%. So 4K is being rendered at around 16 to 17 frames per second. This video was shot at 24 frames per second. So it's like 2/3 the, you know, the speed of the video. So it's almost about to be done, 98%, 99%, and it's done. So it took 1 minute and 41 seconds to render a 1-minute clip. So I think that was pretty good performance, and I'm really impressed by this thin and light laptop. It's very comfortable to, you know, take it around with you wherever you are. Right now, obviously we are all quarantined, so you can't go anywhere. But still, you know, it's a light portable laptop with fantastic performance, 8 cores, 16 thread, 16 GB RAM. So this laptop will literally throw whatever you want to throw on this laptop, and it will handle it without any problem. So I think if you are a student, if you are going back to school, you are looking for a good laptop to, you know, take notes in classroom. It has a touch screen, so you can also, you know, get an active stylus and write down notes, equations, formulas, right? If you are in a math or an engineering class, or if you are an artist and you want to like draw and sketch, you can do all that. And you can do video editing, and obviously you can do photo editing. So I think the performance on this laptop and the bang for bucks that you are getting, it's pretty good. This is actually my favorite touchscreen laptop in the market right now. Of all the other ones that I have tested, I think this is giving the best bang for bucks. And the plus is that the screen is actually quite good. It's a nice IPS panel. So it's really nice when you are working on, you know, when you are consuming media, or when you are, you know, doing some creative work. I love the screen. And like I showed here, the performance is top notch. By the way, you can get Intel configuration of this laptop, but honestly, I don't see the point of buying an Intel configuration of this laptop now that you have 6 and 8 core Ryzen configuration available. So I'm going to link all the configuration of this laptop in the video description below. I will recommend that you go with either a 6-core or an 8-core configuration. But if you are an Intel fanboy, right, or for whatever reason you want to check out Intel configuration, I will link those also. Okay, so I think I will wrap up here. I just wanted to make a short video to show the performance of this laptop. And, you know, if you are thinking of buying this laptop, hopefully this video will, you know, help you make a purchasing decision. So if you guys have any other question, or if you want me to test anything else on this laptop, please let me know. I'm thinking of making a video, you know, where I try out various games like Fortnite and some other games. So let me know if you want to see that video. Put a comment in the comment section below if you would like to see that video, and I would, you know, love to make a video on that. So that's it for today, guys. Please like this video and subscribe to TechnoPanda for more videos like this. Also check out TechnoPandaReviews.com for all the reviews of various laptops, gaming laptops and desktop PCs that I have done on this channel. They are all consolidated on that website. So again, guys, thanks for watching this video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.